on Shadow Fiend. I think maybe they'll try to run it again, maybe without the Clockwork support, maybe with it or something. That's like some of the ones that I was kind of expecting, just to like try out those strategies that they've used and didn't work every like into their favors all the time. So I don't know. Should be an interesting day.
It will be an interesting day, and I believe right now we are actually in the draft, so
that'll be perfect timing.
It's been a little while, but here we go. We have an Ogre ban, surprise, and an ODIO, surprise, and a Ludo ban. That means Batrider and Bounty Hunter are both still in the pool.
Draw Ranger.
Oh, we're back. Okay, we're not doing any fun stuff, guys.
Now we're going back to some TI.
We're just going back.
There's a classic super TI serious.
Yeah. They're like, oh, you pick Illusion Heroes? Warlock. And Draw Ranger kind of just... Yeah, Draw Ranger.
Yeah.
VP goes for the Slardar. Wow, okay. So they are...
VP did have 9 Pasha play Slardar as well yesterday, so it's a bit... Could be going either way.
Was that we've seen a little bit of everything, right? We've seen the 4 and the 3 Slardar, right?
Yeah. They've. I don't think they've ever put it on Ramses.
No. But,
it's either 9 Pasha or Lil.
Yeah,
leaves it
altered a bit. Yeah.
Well, they are definitely in a little bit of a hurry here.
Keep each other on their toes.
Yeah,
Jug Ban. Great with Slardar. Great with Juggernaut, Illusion Hero, Illusion Edgy Hero. Very
Ten seconds remaining. Dire team
bad.
Dark.
It's gonna be a. Do you think Edwin are gonna go for bottom or not?
I think they.
Okay.
They probably won't.
So.
They've got the SD set up, so that leaves like their draft really open though.
Yeah.
You don't know where the Mirana is gonna go. You don't know where the Slardar is gonna go just yet. Gives you a lot of flexibility.
But what you do know is that Adfinim is gonna team fight.
And they're gonna pick Bounty Hunter right here or Ursa. Oh no, not Ursa. I lied. Definitely not Ursa.
But they're gonna fight a lot.
Yeah.
Is there anything that, because Virtus.pro can't really team fight that well right now? Yeah. Or am I missing something?
Yeah. So they go bounty. Yeah. They always do the Darkseer Bounty Hunter, and VP goes straight for their Ramsey's Life Stealer, which is probably one of his best win rates, and he usually goes. Like, I think godlike on that hero pretty much every time. I feel like that's what I don't know. I just feel like I see Lifesteal go godlike every time he's in a game. Pocket.
Yeah. I mean, it's like, no, I'm just trying to think about these two. Like, it's like the two strategies, right?
If
the Dire team, like, what they're going to go, they want to try to kill Roche, VP. You know, they have easy Roche. They have a lot of physical damage. So they can burst down heroes really fast. Like, an Infest Bomb, you go in with Slardar, with Pot of Malt. And then you know you kill one hero, you remove maybe the Warlock or the Darkseer, some important hero, even the Draw Ranger, and then you take the fire from there, preferably with an Aegis already because you can kill Roche so fast. And then at Finem, they just want to overpower them in the lanes. I mean, Darkseer pressures lanes together with the Bounty Hunter, then Draw Warlock pressures the safe lane a lot, and then they want to have a lot of like items from the laning stage, and then they want to pressure VP from there.
So what complements the lineups as fifth picks?
I think that this looks like it's gonna be an offlane Slardar, no? I mean, it totally depends. It's up to them. Yeah,
depends on what they want to do, how they feel.
It's very open for them.
Well, they're gonna have to reveal before at Finem picks, so that's like a downside for them, I guess. What are we thinking for
like
at Finem?
I feel like VP could do something. If they want to go offlane Slardar, I wouldn't mind having something like a Kunga, because then they can just take the fights. They don't have to care as much about the rock. They can actually just run in. And with the boat, and then even they drop a rock, you just go in and you can still fight. It could even set them up for like doing dual lanes. They can go with like Slardar Kunkka. It's a pretty strong lane. They could go like you go aggressive China with SD Kunkka and Naix.
Yeah.
And then you can split them up so that you can have the Naix sit bottom on the off lane with either the SD or the Kunkka, and Slardar plus either one of the two. Preferably the Kunkka makes a really strong dual lane. But I don't know if they play the Kunkka that much.
Ooh, I said Pudge before the draft, but
you did.
Oh my god, they instant picked Alchemist.
And it's already done?
Yeah,
okay,
they instantly picked Alchemist. I guess they didn't even care what they were going to pick, but...
Nope, they got a Pudge.
Yeah,
so
that's good.
A little bit of a change, but not
such a
super
fast draft.
Yeah,
like, holy crap. It's probably the fastest of the season.
Yeah, that was...
The Pudge is not that much of
quick.
A like uncommon pick anymore.
No, it's been coming more...
I think that Virtus.Pro is gonna do a little bit better.
I think so.
I'm not forgetting one Virtus.Pro.
I don't want to go against Ramsey's Lifestealer, but I will for my Greek boys. Let's go. I mean, MNT Bounty Hunter.
Okay, I'm also gonna go with the VP.
Okay,
I think they got this.
Yeah,
I think they got that too. Let's find out what our commentators think about this this first game of the night. It is at Finem versus Virtus.Pro with OD Pixel and Gods. 10 seconds remaining.
5 seconds remaining.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Aces RG Dream League. I'm Odie Pixel, I'm here with Gods, and we're ready to take you through the first hand-only series of the day. It is, of course, at Finem up against VP. Now, obviously, coming into this, we were saying, Lil said he was going to draft some ruffle shit. We have the first four picks, kind of the dirtiest stuff ever. They get the Shadow Demon, Lifestealer, Mirana. It's a lot of that is, that's not fun. That is destroying your opponent's kind of will to play the game of Dota 2. But then they finish it off with a Pudge. Still, though, for at Finem, they've got a lot of kind of, it's at Finem, you know what I mean? They have got their Bounty Hunter. They've got the Alk. Wall Up is going to be interesting to see kind of how the game goes on for them. A little bit different, but VP, for the most part, it's a try-hard draft.
I think they saw that first stage Drow, and they're just like, these guys are going to pick Drow. We'll show them Drow. And I mean, the draft they've got, not by any means amazingly directly countering the Drow, but there's a lot of physical damage. Slider, Lifestealer can wreck a Drow. The fifth pick, Pudge, is actually something which can counter the Drow in laning stage. You just sit around in those trees. If you hit a hook on a Drow, she has nothing really against you. You may be forced to get an early point in Gust, but it is a nice pick against Drow in general. But interesting to see how Adfinim do. The Alchemist pick, perhaps the hero we haven't really seen much of. It didn't get played much in the qualifiers, hasn't been played much here in the Aces RG Dream League. But one of those heroes that if you let him farm, if he does somehow end up getting big, he is going to be an absolute monster.
It was one of those heroes, I think, that was a lot of times in the second phase would be banned out, wouldn't it? I think in the qualifiers.
Yeah.
So teams would ban it. Not necessarily because, I don't know, just because they don't want to bother playing against it. It just prolongs the game. It changes the game.
In the BO1s especially, because that's where it's like you don't want to lose a game to an Alk, where it's like we feel like we're a better team than our opponents, but they just picked this Alchemist where we didn't draft a way of dealing with the hero, or we didn't adjust our playstyle to counter the hero. So it very much is a hero you have to react to when you see it. You reach this timing where you've got all these big items and suddenly you're almost unstoppable. You can get six slotted pre 30 minutes. One of the probably only heroes in the game that can do that. So it does force you to adapt accordingly.
Well, here we have it, ladies and gentlemen. It's kicking off. Adfinim versus VP. Either way, we should see some fun stuff go down, that's for sure. I mean, whether it be the rotations from Lil or the wombo combos from Adfinim with the Darkseer and Spartans. Golem's pings at the moment.
Pinging
who?
What's he done? There was two players on his team pinging him.
It was Orange. It was MNT and
I think Orange as well. Skylark.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. They're not happy. Madara, what's wrong with you? Smoker's pop.
Oh,
Thug says hello and goodbye. Oh, he's out. He's been hit.
He may be in trouble.
Disruption to Crush, it's coming.
Yep, get Pasher in, nice and close and personal. And Thug, he's going down here in the mid lane, boys and girls. That's going to be first blood for VP.
Question is, can he get back out in time to still find the bounty rune? 22 seconds. He's got a TP. He's going to likely TP out and get the Greaves. Get the Greaves.
I was going to say, pre-game Greaves. That's good farm for an out.
That's how fast this hero farms, I'm telling you. Madara scouting out the high ground. Oh, God.
He's going for bottom out.
Yeah, he is. That's where the fight is.
Pasha's already trying to lead in. He's got the Shadow Word ticking him down. They're going to be able to create the space. Thug's terrified. He's not going to go for the rune. Pasha's going to be able to take it bottom. No one's going to be able to take it top. So VP with the first blood. And maybe even more Pasha coming in with a three-man crush. They're fairly low on VP. They've got to be a little bit careful. Lil bringing them down there with the rock. Madara's gone. They found themselves a second. They've lost the SD. They do end up losing the slider as well. So MNT picks up a double kill.
Yep.
So at the end of the day, two for two trade, but VP did get the first blood and they did get both of the runes as well.
Blocking the Alchemist getting a rune, definitely the big win there. Acid Spray was just leveled up. Once you realize you're not getting that rune or there's going to be a fight, you just have to level that Acid sometimes, but couldn't quite do it. As we'll see, the SD looked to pressure mid. There was an arrow, but I don't think no one was trying to hit land. I think he just wanted to get the range creep, so. The good news for Adfinim is MNT's start. He's got a double kill. He got a solo kill on the Shadow Demon behind the action at the start. Then he finishes off the slider. So he's got early boots, Orb of Venom. He's going to have a very fast level two. So he's the player that needs to kind of come up big here in the early game. Problem is he's dealing with a Pudge who's doing a similar thing, roaming around with Dust.
Roaming to mid lane, Lil gets a few punches in, but MNT is going to be there to try and turn around. Lil, he might have to look to try and kill himself. MNT looking for the final touch, but Lil, he's too speedy with the wind lace. Gets himself out with the suicide.
No one might be dead here. He's got no leap. Oh, body blocks coming in.
Yeah.
And then he gets leap from there. From a creep danger tower.
Yeah, Thug will save himself back up, and so will no one. Get themselves back into a better position. Up top, Skylock was going in hard. Onto Ramsey's bringing him low for solo. Coming through to force the Darkseid to back off. Bottom lane, Spartan and Pasha trading hits. Spartan has the heal, so Pasha can't quite fight through it. Still has a Mango, still has another crush. And we'll see if he gets himself back in there with the help of Lil. Meanwhile, top lane, MNT and Skylock with the old Invis Iron Shell. Pretty fail safe. Gets another kill as Bounty. One minute and 45 seconds in on a killing spree. MNT could not hope for a better start this game.
Yeah, it's pretty good for a bounty to have a start like this.
Bottom lane, the combo again. Lil with these rotations gets the kill. There's Fatal Bonds and Shadow Word down on Pasha. Lil's trying to man up against Spartan. Spartan going for the right-click war, but Lil, he should win this one here. Another punch. Oh, Crush will ensure that Lil, he's going to have to kill himself. Yep. Can he do it? No, he can't. He can't do it. Shadow Word. The ticks get him around the damage from his own rot.
Yep.
But four for four. 2 minutes in, it's all kicking off. But the thing is, I guess, the fact that the trades are even, Lil, of course, he's getting himself involved. When he finally levels up Flesh Sheep, he's already going to have a good number of stacks built up.
Yeah. It's definitely good start for the Pudge. Same, both four position players coming up big here. We talked about potential MVPs, and we had Lil as well as MNT, and they're both making good arguments for themselves here. A killing spree on a bounty hunter, Pudge with four kill involvement early on as well. Very good start for both these players.
Skylock and MNT have eyes on to solo, and they've got to be careful VP in this lane, because obviously with
Lil smoked up top, he wants to turn this one around.
Yep, let's see if Lil can do something big. Still just level two, but that's all you need. He's got the hook, he's got the rot. They're going to look to set up, surround the bounty hunter. Soul Catcher, is he going to get lucky with the target? They may not need it though. They're going to turn towards Skylock and dead. They see Skylock searching up MNT. They say, all right, we won't take the bounty, we'll take you instead then. The bigger kill, arguably, for VP. As they take down the offlaner, Ramsey's gets the gold.
Kind of the bigger kill, but MNT was on the killing spree. And that's where ending would have been really nice for them. They're probably kind of equal as far as what you kill. You're just going to go forever's not surge. You surge the bounty to save his life, then you just change target immediately.
Yeah, top lane again. Looks like they're going to have another bit of a go. The hook lands, bringing MNT back, and here's that killing spree you're talking about. VP will end it. Lil getting himself a tasty bit of a bounty. Skylock's coming in with the surge, the Iron Shell held back by solo. Lil, he may even try and come back in with another hook. We're seeing them look to set up onto Skylock, slowing him down. Lil looking to get the angle. They've got to move the illusions out of the way. Skylock hiding behind the creeps. Lil can't get the angle that he needs to. He may go back. Oh, Lil. Lil? No. He's about to. Oh, he nearly messes up. He just managed to kill himself. I mean, he wasn't getting the kill, but he knew.
Ambitious.
I'm sure he calculated. He was like, I'll try for it. If the damage isn't enough, I'll be able to kill myself.
Yeah, surely. He's like confidence, you know?
Yeah, pro player.
Oh, boy. Mid lane, Pasha's rotating in, looking for what looks to be three-man rotation towards the Alkin.
That's got to be.
He's not ready for it.
Very, very careful here. Crush to set up, allow Lil to get in range with the Starstorm burst as well. Thug's gone, and VP with another successful rotation. Lil now involved in all seven of the kills in this first 4.5 minutes. We said the Pudge was going to be the ruffle pick, but it's working out absolutely perfectly, and VP are showing us that they're not clowning around this game.
Yeah. I mean, outside of the Pudge, it's very standard draft, and Pudge is a hero. We're seeing a lot of four position players kind of start picking up. We saw Puppy have a lot of success with it for a while on Secret. We've seen it just come out here and there, and this is definitely one of the better games so far.
He knows that the Darkseid has gone to this camp.
Very low.
Oh, Skylark's got to be a little bit careful here. Lil can find this. He knows that the creeps are being put again. Meanwhile, mid lane, no one trying to go in onto Thug, but MNT's there. He has the Alks back. Top lane, Lil, he's going in. He's found Skylark, and Skylark, can he play his way out? He'll go for the surge. Can Lil hit the hook? He holds on. No, he gets the angle wrong. Skylark jukes to the left. We'll be fine. Lil could be in a bit of a trouble himself now. MNT's coming through. Skylark popping the Sol Ring. Needs to try and get the Iron Shell on into MNT, but Lil, he's already too speedy by the looks of it. Backing off. Now there's the surge. If they get another touch with Lil, he could be dead.
He looks wants to suicide!
Oh, he's trying to suicide! Oh, if he did that, that would have been a right little play, that would have. But he doesn't get away with it. MNT will take down Lil and get the kill.
Yeah, MNT just holding the Shuriken, knowing there's no way a Pudge can deny himself with Rot if he holds Shuriken to the last second, and even the neutral was not going to be anywhere near enough because of that Shuriken. Nice bit of play, MNT now. Four of the five kills he's been involved in. It's been a very solid start there.
I'll shoot the arrow down here, just making sure no one was looking for the rune on the side of Abfidim. That won't be the case, no one able to just grab it. Top his bottle back up. Still 7-5. In terms of farm around the lanes, as you can see, the two highest CS both on the side of VP, but it's very, very close in terms of what the safe lane and the off lane. Obviously, mid lane, that's where we're seeing the most struggle for Abfidim. Thugs being held back on this Alchemist in the early game.
Yeah, absolutely. His start is pretty slow for now. He's kind of fallen back in the jungle trying to finish his level 6, but without that chemical rage, dangerous lane to be in. They used a nice little high ground scan there to try and find the Alk, but not the case as he's backed off to the jungle already. Still a very vulnerable Alk in this mid lane, and that's something that VP may look to exploit. Slider could rotate in again. We've seen that move once before, and that's something that it looks like Pasha may be trying to make happen again.
They've got this ward behind the tier one, so he sees the movements from Thug. Thug has got chemical rage, and the question is if they can actually kill him through that. With an arrow, they may have had a chance, but indeed he jukes it out. If they land the hook, though, no, it's not going to quite have the length or the angle. The block's going to be there.
Heads up probably from Thug to kind of double back. Normally you just run in that straight line back to base, but he expects the arrow coming in, knows that if it's placed into his running path, he's going to walk into it, so good kind of read from him. Dire's bottom
tower is under attack. Mid lane, the pressure's starting to be put on Pasha. He's going to head back over. They'll gust him back, and this is going to get them the chance to get a lot of damage in. He's going to go for the straight TP home. Oh, he only just makes it, but he does. Thug very, very close there. Mid lane, though, indeed, Lil's moved in, looking for MNT. And he's going to have to be a little careful. Gets the hook, though, bringing MNT back. He's going to move in for this one as no one jumps forward. They'll take the kill. Lil, he may have his life. Already chasing him down, though. Relays down the acid spray. That'll do the damage. You can't get the suicide out. The acid spray damage overruling the rot at the end of the day.
Yep. Feels like a pretty good sequence of events all in all for Abfidim. Even though they give up a couple of kills, it's the Alk securing a big one on the Pudge. I believe that was Pudge on a killing spree that was ended. So, nice bit of play there. Abfidim also take the bottom tier 1 tower with Madara. He's hit level 6, close to level 7 now. The Warlock also about to hit level 6. So it feels like Abfidim will hit this nice timing where they can kind of fight as 4 using the Darkseer Bounty Duo as well as the Warlock and Drow and create space for Alchemists just to jungle it up and farm elsewhere on the map, because with that Chaotic Offering, they get a whole lot scarier when they're 5-manning.
Still on this top lane. Skylark trying to do his best to put the pressure onto Ramzes. But as we've seen so far, Ramzes getting absolutely fine farm up at the top lane. Mid lane, MNT coming in, looking for the courier. One more touch and he's got it. Man, that's got the bottle on. He'll take it. Very nicely done there from MNT. Knocking the bottle out of the game for a few minutes. You kind of passed the laning stage, so I guess it won't hurt no one too much, but it's still a little bit annoying for VP.
Yep, definitely annoying. The money for Abfidim really boosts on. You can see, like, net worth, they suddenly actually have the top 2 most farmed heroes in the game, and that's as a result of the courier, and more importantly, probably the tower, but two big things like that. Alk is kind of where he wants to be, top of the net worth. They're about to hit level 6 on MNT's bounty at mid lane, so a lot of things coming together nicely for Abfidim. The one item timing they're kind of looking to perhaps a bit now is the mech on Darkseer. Ooh. With mech Darkseer, they can actually start really pushing and taking objectives.
Yeah, level 6 on MNT, so tracks can start to be thrown out. VP with this rotation, smoking up and looking towards what seems to be the mid lane. Lil leading the way, they're going to have their eyes on to Thug. A good hook, and they could certainly get away with this kill. We'll see if Lil can get the angle right, and he can. Beautifully done. Brings Thug up to the high ground. He has the chemical rage. It's not going to be enough to keep him alive by the looks of it. And indeed it isn't. VP take the kill, and Lil again with these rotations. And with that kill, putting himself very close to having the level 6 on Pudge.
Yeah, that's some nice hooks coming out from Lil's Pudge so far. It's one of those things where you look at his scoreline and you're like, oh, Pudge is 4-5-5. He's not really having a good game, but Lil's made everything happen in this early game for VP.
And most of those deaths have been suicides.
Yep. I think 3 of the 5 have been suicides, I want to say.
I want to say so, yeah.
Possibly even 4, but yeah, as it is, it's a great start. Top lane is where Abfidim have made their move. They've brought Warlock up here with the Rock. They've got Darkseer. They've got Drow Ranger. This is where they want to really push and take objectives. Bounty's not sure really this is a kill he can get on his own. It's not. He's only doing this with some backup and some help, so.
I mean, at least I guess he can prepare.
He wants to
cancel
a TP, yeah, exactly. He's thinking, I can stay in this neighborhood. If they want to defend top lane on VP, they've got a TP in the Slider. So, admit he got scattered, though. He did invis in a slight bit of sight of the opponent, so he's going to stay down, keep tabs on Slider, just be ready to cancel his TP, and this basically secures the top tower. Dyer's top tower. As MNT will get amped up at bottom. He could be in some trouble here.
He's got to be careful how he plays his way around this one, trying to get himself out of range of Pasha, but Pasha hits the crush. TPs will come through. Can they save MNT? Well, with the turnaround, the Shuriken's there. Thinking about dropping the rock, but Spahn holds on. Lil looks for the hook. He's not going to find it. Now him himself a little bit revealed in the position, so he backs away. They'll drop down the sentry. So no one to fall on that bottom lane.
Yeah, some good team play from Ad Finem with the rotation, bringing in the Warlock just in time to help out Bounty. He fumbled a bit there, getting caught by the amp when he popped out of invis. He tried to kind of re-invis fast enough not to get amp, but Slider was ready for it, and we'll see Ad Finem perhaps with numbers down towards his bottom lane, consider even rotating in Drow, but realistically this is this kind of stage of the game where they just want to farm up a bit. Ad Finem can rotate Madara into the jungle, he can farm Ancients on Drow Ranger. It does take that farm away from the Alchemist, but and that may be a reason to keep on grouping up with your team. Kind of say five manning, but it's really just four manning. It's the five heroes minus Alchemist who are normally pushing, but this time around they do consider bringing Alchemist. He's got treads early on, so he's going for that little bit of extra fight potential. He's even got 2 points in the Unstable Concoction, so a unconventional Alchemist build.
I mean, I want to say as well, wasn't it Thug the other day who did the whole Medallion Solar Crest fighting?
It was, yeah.
It was Thug, wasn't it? I mean, in a game where the tempo's like this, do you think we will see the Radiance, or do you think we could see the fighting out?
We could see a Solar Crest against the physical damage.
Oh, we could also see this man getting caught out. Indeed, that's Warlock out before he gets the chance to drop the ult. He's actually going to buy back because he realizes the team needs him for this fight. He'll TP in, VP are aware, of course, and they back up. They know he's going to want to drop the rock with this solo. He's going to be left for dead on the sidelines. They did end up losing two for that one. Especially if they can get anything more. Spahn playing around with the Golem, not wanting to drop it down on no one. He's got the leap available, so almost certainly will be able to get himself away. But Ad Finem with the pressure, they'll take the mid-tier one, and they'll possibly try and move on for more with the full five man alive. Did cost them the buyback, but VP, they lost two heroes. I think Ad Finem's fine with this.
Yep. Ad Finem's fine. It's a buyback on your lowest net worth hero, and it's your five position support. So, yeah, Warlock, you've got 1k net worth, but realistically, making sure VP don't chase and get more kills is a decent trade. It was such a cheap buyback as well.
That's a big hook. He's caught Madara, but the Golem will be dropped. They're building up the concoction as well, looking for Lil with the Shuriken bounce. They'll take it. That's a track kill for Ad Finem. LNT getting the rest of them laid out. Track onto no one. Pashy comes back in with a crush. They've got the Demonic Pledge as well, though. Falling Lil will be searched out. He's looking for the armor toggle. He's going to make it by the looks of it. He's going to be fine. He's got the Shadow Word heal. He should be okay. The Fatal Ponce as well is just wrecking VP. They've lost three. Pasha trying to crush and run as they get themselves back up to the high ground. MNT with the track. He hasn't got the mana for Shuriken. So the rest of VP will get away. But Ad Finem absolutely turning that around there. You see the initiation from Lil, but immediately spawns there with the drop. They've got the Fatal Bonds on them all, and just the AoE damage, it destroys VP in that fight.
Yeah, it's a fairly ambitious hook initiation when you're versing a Warlock, because Warlock is always going to use that opportunity to drop the Chaotic Offering on that two-man rock there. It's a raged-up Lifestealer, so it doesn't really hurt the Lifestealer too much initially, but Pudge is an insta-free kill for them. It saves the Alchemist's life, so Ad Finem are going to make that counterplay every single time, and that's where VP perhaps had to reconsider their approach.
Oh, no one. He's got his eyes on Spahn. He's going to try for an arrow. He's not going to get it. Meanwhile, Lil actually just took the kill for free off Madara.
that works.
Lil just picking off heroes left, right, and center. Had the ward up here. Looks like Madara was going for a bit of an ancient farm, so Lil had the perfect chance to set up. And I mean, Lil, of course, level 8 now.
Yep.
And having a very, very good game on the Pudge. But Ad Finem, as we're seeing, when they group up as a team, VP sort of struggling to deal with them when Ad Finem come at them as a full five man.
Yeah, and that's where Ad Finem is strong, when they're grouped up as a unit. And they probably want to continue taking that approach, considering the Alchemist build. And the fact they've got this Alk, who is a good couple thousand net worth ahead of Lifesteal. The Drow is nice and farmed, has the Hurricane Pike. They've got all their core items, really. As far as these heroes are concerned, Alk is going to go into what looks to be the Solar Crest. He's camping the courier at the shop, so he just needs to finish off the Talisman. And we're going to see a very early Solar Crest Alchemist with 3 points in stun. He'll have his second point in Chemical Rage. He'll be a pretty strong fighting hero.
It's scary. With this kind of lineup, you track a hero, you Hurricane Pike them on the Drow, you put the Solar Crest, and they melt in the four hits. They literally do. Bottom lane, again, the setup from Pasha, allowing Lil to hit the hook. Scarlet's got the mech. He'll vacuum them, surge off. He's actually going to be able to play this one off by the looks of it, and indeed, he's out of there. Shadow Word's there. He jukes out the Blink Crush, and now Lil's in trouble. Thug and Spartan turning up, chasing down the Pudge. They'll take the kill. And again, Ad Finem managing to play their way out of it. Skylark playing his way. He was, you know, two heroes going in on him, and he gets himself out of there.
MNT at mid. That's not gonna work.
The armlet toggle indeed, too strong for MNT Shurikens.
He was ready with the sentry. Nice little bait by the lifestealer. Walks back in the sentry, turns around with the well-timed armlet toggle to get him. MNT was not ready for that.
That's a bit of a smoke round here.
Yeah, I'm not sure if that was intended or not. It does look like it was.
They've got the position with the golem and with the vacuum wall.
It's actually pretty nice to be smoked in where you'd normally be visible, because if VP come to contest this, they'd ideally like to burst the wall off and prevent him from getting off a rock. But because he's smoked, they'll initiate another hero.
Hook onto Thugs, though. He's going to be surrounded by three of them. The Shadow Word Hill is not going to be enough from Spartan. And they've lost Thug on this, and Roshan at about a third of his health. VP are going to want to get in here, and they may even find more. Leading the way with the Moonlight Shadow, Lil tries for a hook, but Madara's already out of there with the rest of the boys. Pasha from the sideline may go in for a leading crush, but they've already caught him out. They're Finem, they've still got four, and they're four fighting struggles. They focus down Pasha, take Slaughter out of the fight, and now VP, they have to be again a little bit careful.
Yeah, Spam was just a little bit too far away to get the rock off when Alp got hooked, and it was also this really awkward point where you have to go all the way around the cliff because of where the ramps are. So it just wasn't really possible for him to get the rock to help the out unless he was inside the pit. But he doesn't want to be inside the pit because that's like a spot where he's going to get hooked out or he's going to get blinked on by a Slaughter. So it's kind of this catch 22 where if you're in the pit, you're in a bad position. But if you're outside the pit, you can't get off the rock to help out there. And we'll see Adfinim maintain this kind of showing at the Roche pit. They really want to go for this one.
They drop a sentry, but VP's still got that high ground ward, so the hook potential's there. They catch out Skylar, bring him in. The rock will be dropped, though. Vacuum coming through, and they manage to take down Lil in return. Solo falling low. He'll Demonic Purge, though, but still the Chaotic Offering Golem chases him down, takes a second. Pasha coming back into the fight. Ramses, he's questioning whether he can offer anything to this engagement. They're playing it safe on VP. They've already lost two. They don't want to throw anything more in. No one's still eyeing them for the high ground.
Oh, nice.
Oh, it will take down the golem, indeed, and Pasha comes in with a three-man crush. The four-man starts on no one jumps forward. They take one, they take two. Thug, he's in trouble as well as Ramsey's focusing with the open wounds. Thug trying to turn, but he's out. They've lost another. There'll be buybacks coming out on two. They're trying to get themselves back into this fight at Finem. They are going to get Pasha. Roshan still standing. No one stuck on the cliff, jumps down, gets the arcane rune. There'll be a buyback from Pasha. This Roshan fight seemingly never-ending from both sides.
Some standoff, yeah. And while this has all been going on, the net worth change is really the big thing that stands out. We had the two Adfinim carries like well ahead on net worth, but now it's back to even.
VP are back into the pit. They're looking to finish it off here. They will try and get the vacuum onto the high ground, but Lil with a dismember onto Madara. No one jumping forward with the Starstorm. No, MNT's going to head down towards the east, but they managed to round Madara. VP have finished off Roshan. They get the Aegis out. They will end up killing the Drow. Jump to the right. They've got vision onto MNT. The dust was out. They'll take down a second, and now Lil, he's chasing down for more. Hook's still on cooldown for 5 seconds, has the vision onto Skylark.
Maybe a blink crash in a second.
Pasha could certainly try and go for a finish, but he's been a little careful about this one. Now he goes in beautifully timed as well, just after the surge was used, so the duration isn't going to be too great. You just need a good hook, and Lil can't quite get it. Skylark, nice juke up to the north, and gets himself out.
Oh, Slider's not done. He's actually going to go for it. Nope. Thinks twice when he sees the surge.
Still very good trade for VP. They use one buyback, Adfinim use two. VP end up with the Roshan, and they end up picking up some big kills as well off the back of it, taking down the Drow and the Bounty Hunter.
They got key kills across it. Even the very start was killing the Alchemist too. It was Alk and Drow who were both like sitting around that 8k net worth mark when the Lifestealer and Mirana were down at like 6.2k, 6.5k. And throughout that Roche standoff where Adfinim lost a number of heroes used buyback, suddenly we see Mirana and Lifesteal as the top two. It was just well-executed Roche contest from VP, and Adfinim were just too keen on forcing Roche. They know that their teamfight's better, but Pudge disrupts teamfights. He pulls a hero so far out of position that it's no longer a teamfight. It's like a 4v5. It turns into this scrappy mess that Adfinim don't want to play around.
Oh, no one's just blinked into this one. They hit the gust. And we'll leap
level
out.
One gas,
yeah, he's good. He's absolutely. He is stuck at the moment.
Trapped, yep.
If they come looking for him, they might find him. He's gonna have blink in a second.
Oh, they saw
the Starstorm's gonna reveal him. In fact, he'll get the arrow out, jumps across. He's gonna be okay. Adfinim can't chase him out. In fact, Adfinim themselves a little bit scared of the position they're in. Solo coming forward. Adfinim do have the ward up on the high ground in Dire's jungle, so they've got pretty good vision around this area when VP come down.
Oh, now Lifestealer with a Desolator is infesting Slaughter. This is an insta-kill on almost any hero. Alchemist, yeah, he's got Solar Crest, but I want to say even that could be close to a kill with the Slaughter amp damage. It's if he's got Rage up and the Armlet turned on, he probably survives it. But with Armlet turned off, the Slatter Lifesteal duo can very well likely kill him as well.
Yeah, for sure.
They smoke up under Detection of Ward, though.
Can't quite get the hook contact. MNT, look for the track. Patchy jumps with the two-man crush. The damage, they've managed to take the Warlock. MNT fully mercy. Ramsey's focuses him. Mill in the wall. He will manage to get the Suicidal. So it's essentially a 2-for-1. Make that a 3-for-1 as Ramsey's picks up another. DP looking to take a very nice trade here. No one jumps forward. Can't quite get the arrow. The neutrals will block it. Ramsey's still looking for the chase down onto Skylark. Will go for the TP, but they've got the vision for the disruption. Solo holds back Skylark. The mech's not going to save the Darkseer. Ad Finem losing 4. VP, they lost the Slardar. Lil Low on the push was able to kill himself. And again, this game getting harder and harder for Ad Finem.
Yeah, again, it's just the inability to counter-initiate with the Warlock Chaos Offering. Spartan gets caught at the start in that crush. He was kind of in fog, but he's a bit unfortunate to get caught with his teammate there. At the same time, he perhaps should have been a bit further back, and his position is probably the single most important factor to a teamfight for Ad Finem. The Warlock at the Roche pit couldn't get the rock off. There at the top lane couldn't get it off. It's very difficult to play that role where you're one of the slower heroes in the game. You have no items. If you ever get caught, you're just instantly dead without getting off a spell. That's a big thing here. He doesn't get off a Fatal Bond. Doesn't, more importantly, get off the Chaotic Offering. He's just instantly taken out. And he needs to be positioned fairly far forward because of the hook. If someone gets hooked, he needs to be there for the rock.
Solo was coming over, and actually with the arrow for no one, they could go for this, but the good turnaround with the rock drop, no one using the Starstorm. MNT gets himself away, it's not going to be enough. The burst comes through from the poison. They've lost the MNT on the Bounty Hunter. Meanwhile, Lil able to pick off a second as he grabs Warlock in the mid lane.
And they committed rock for this. I think VP will press forward and try and punish.
Ramses, can you get the range for the opponents? No, Skylark's too far out. But yeah, still, again, it's good trades for VP. They're the ones putting the pressure on now. And Ad Finem, as you said, they dropped the Chaotic Offering for that. And they're not going to have it for this defense. And VP could end up pushing in pretty hard at this stage of the game.
Yeah, the timings have just kind of been missed by Ad Finem. They were gathering some momentum early on and doing a good job of taking down Tower's objectives, getting Alchemist and Drought in a position where they were really succeeding. They were getting a good amount of farm. They were out farming their counterparts on the VP side. Then things just fell apart through that Roshan, really forcing the issue a bit too much there. The vision, I guess, was the big key reason why VP were able to contest it, and also just the hero lineup. So you've got Hook, you've got Arrow, you've got these very safe ways to contest Roshan. You can throw an arrow, if it lands, you follow it up. You throw a hook, if it lands, you kill the hero in the Roshan pit. And if they don't land, you're not compromising yourselves. You're not out of position through doing this. Shadow Poison, similar thing. Very good at scouting out your opponents around that Roche pit. So something that Ad Finem just over-invested in was that Roche. Radiant's bottom
tower is under attack. And now VP just taking towers off the hands of Ad Finem with relative Radiant's ease. Bottom lane, they'll find the tier one. And with the full five down here, they may push on for another. Ad Finem themselves, though, positioned in VP's jungle. And with creep wave pushed up to their tier two, we'll see is possibly just going to be a trade for a trade. But
yep.
VP may have the potential to get back and defend as well.
They could likely push nice and fast and get back. Drought pushes very fast to assault, though. But this top tier 2 is something, if they want to defend it, they'd need to be TPing now to the tier 3s. And they can do it. They're going to glyph, TP, Pudge back with the, Slaughter with the Infested Lifesteal. They're looking to fight.
Yep. And they have found a Bounty on the easiest kill of VP's life, but they take down one. Hold on to the tower.
A dandy sentry ward to have lying on the ground.
Bottom lane, looking for no one. They got the gust, but again, the duration wasn't there, so no one's out of there.
They can turn around.
They want to go back in. They really do. So they're hitting the Disruption Soul Catcher onto Madara, forcing him to back up.
No one's considering it.
With the Demonic Pudge. Let me do this one. Jump forward, Starstorm. The Shadow Word Heal is going to be enough. They've got the hook onto the Warlock. Gust will not back the Pudge, but they move in. Pashy getting the crush onto three. Amplify Stug. No one just jumping through the middle of the fight, trying to finish off Spawn with the Starstorm, and he will do it. Madara to fall as well. And VP, they'll continue to chase. Stug will be able to blink away. But again, VP. Well, they may even fire Skylark as well. Looking for the arrow, Skylark juking out to the left, but they get the vision for it. Pashy jumps in with the crush. They've got the lifestealer inside the Slardar again. Another kill for VP, 30 for 18. They took the tier 2 bottom. They keep the tier 2 alive top. It feels like Ad Finem are running out of options now.
Yeah. It's impressive. They've been 11-1 on that Darkseer up until this game. It definitely that and the probably has been Skylark's best hero. That and the Batrider.
And just plays like this. Yep. Instantly in with a crush. Lil's there with the reaction. And, you know, you've just knocked an Alchemist out of the game for a minute. And VP can continue to be pretty much free to do as they please across the map. They'll split back up across the lanes, continue to farm. No one's got his Eagle Song ready to finish into that E-Blade very, very shortly.
They've just fully taken over the Radiant Jungle. Yeah. There's sentries, there's vision everywhere. No one's farming it up even. He's just trying to find another pick as someone, like a support comes into ward or D-ward. Spartan's actually kind of making that move. He needs to be careful. If he gets hit by an arrow, no one will happily take an extra freebie kill.
And I like this as well from Ramsey, something that we don't see every day. But he says, well, the silence is kind of annoying. Let's get a Manta style on the Lifestealer.
Sure.
Just something to help, you know, against being caught out by Madara. Also for duking out the concoction. There's a lot of things that it's very useful for him this game.
Yep. Get rid of the track even. Yeah. There's just small little things that you can do with this. So why not, I guess? It's the kind of item where you're ahead and the way you die. If you get Gust and you die before you rage, like that could just be a turnaround moment. So having a Manta style, not an amazing idea by any means, but definitely can't hurt you. Five man smoke. This feels like a kind of all-in-ish play.
They wanted it. They've got all the ults,
but they need to find a way to use them. That observable was placed under a sentry, so VP
know
exactly where Advent
are. Yeah, the ping's coming out already, and they're gonna moonlight, and they're gonna look to try and fight themselves solo, leading the way. See if he gets an opening. Pasha comes in with a crush, and he's caught again. The wall off on the sideline. Spartan's down, and he's not gonna have the chance to drop the golem. GG's just gonna be cool just like that. It indeed was Ad Finem's final bit of gun-ho attempt to get into the game with a big team fight, but they didn't find it. VP absolutely on fire this opening game. And, well, Lil on the punch, it really wasn't a clown. It was an absolutely legit pick. He had a great time in the early game, transitioned really nicely into the late, just constantly being there to follow through on Pasha's blink crushes, bringing heroes out of the fight. Ramsey's 11-1-12. I mean, what more can you say? This is the VP that we were used to seeing.